Dear God, as this audience bows their head and heart in this solemn moment here of closing of this Bible lecture, when we see the vindication of the Holy Spirit that shook this nation back and forth and back and forth, great revivals and indications, knowing that something has to follow that, and then see those seven angels come down there on top of that mountain down in Arizona, when even the magazines across the nations packed it, to see Jesus Himself there in the skies looking down and saying in the Revelation 10:7, in the seventh angel's message, these seals would be opened, the mysteries of God would be made known, that the reformers didn't live long enough to bring it out, and here these seven seals that seal the whole thing is to be opened in this day. To see all these great signs and wonders that's been done, vindicated, foretold before it happened, and not one time have you ever failed us, but brought it to pass just as it was said. Dear God, we realize that Jesus Christ is in our midst. We know that He is here. He is here tonight. The invisible God is here with us and can confirm every promise that He made in His Word. How you have stood and proved to them with backs turned in the original beginning before the impersonators even entered the ring, Lord, or entered into the race as it was. You showed and proved, prophesied and told exactly the way it would happen, and we see it's happened that way. And Father God, we know it cannot be man, it has to be God. So we know it's You here tonight. Forgive us of our sins. Dear God, You healed our sickness. Now forgive our sins, Lord, of not being the kind of Christian that we should be, not professing to be a full gospel man or woman, and yet we find ourselves slumping off like a denominational chicken. Help us, dear God. Take us and shake us with Your Holy Spirit. And if there be any thing in us that's not like You, take it out of us, Lord, and plant our feet on God's Holy Word, and let the Holy Ghost burn down into our heart and take all the dross of unbelief and the drowsiness of this day. Oh, arise and shake ourselves. Grant it, God. Cleanse us, mold us, make us. God, grant it. If there's any in here tonight, Lord, is holding in their heart that grain, that gene of God that's ordained to life from the foundation of the world, I know, Lord, that they're bound to hear at this hour. So I pray, God, that You'll fill their soul and illuminate them with a fresh baptism of the Holy Ghost and send them on their road rejoicing and happy. Lord God, they are given to You. I don't know who they are. You do. I'm only responsible for preaching Your Word, Lord, as You reveal it. You're responsible for the rest of it. Where the seed falls, I just throw it. Lord God, I pray that it fell in good, rich soil tonight, that it, many will see it, Lord, and rise to shining Christians in this last days, that the great thing that we're looking forward to come will come quickly. Grant it, Lord, and You'll take Your church, Your bride, and take her home. We see it all setting in order. Come, Lord Jesus. We commit it all to You in the name of Jesus Christ for the results. Amen.